Back in the days of sailing ships, people from all over the world were coming to America, looking for a new start in life. There was this one ship named the White Cloud, and it's her last voyage that this tale is about. She set sail for the New World with a full passenger list. Now, these folks weren't poor like a lot of the early settlers. They brought things of great value, like jewels and gold heirlooms. And while they tried to keep these things hidden, on a small ship, the word gets around among the crew. Now, the captain of the White Cloud had been a pirate when he was younger, but was given a pardon by the king because of the shortage of experienced sea captains. When he heard about the treasures on board, his thoughts turned back to the old pirate ways. He plotted with the crew to murder the passengers, take their belongings, set fire to the ship, and escape in the longboat. On the last night out of port, the murderous crew crept below with knives drawn. They spared no one. Every single passenger was brutally killed. Then a plunder began. Sea bags were slashed open. Trunks were bashed apart. Everything of value was piled on deck and divided among the thieves. After they had loaded the longboat, the captain set fire to the White Cloud, and the smaller boat pulled away from the flaming hull. Suddenly the wind shifted. The ship, now a mass of flames, bore down directly on the longboat. The villains laid to the oars, but it was no use. With a thunderous, fiery crash, the blazing ship split the small boat in half, and the evil crew was dumped screaming into the fiery sea. And all hands were lost. Since that infernal night, every year, on the first new moon of the fall, the flaming ship reappears. You can hear the eerie screams of terror from the tormented men as the blazing ghost ship nears the shore. She suddenly bursts into a great fireball, then disappears, only to appear again moments later. This happens three times. After the third explosion, no matter the direction of the wind, the blazing sea-gone inferno disappears over the horizon, always to the northeast, not to be seen again for a full year. Folks who have seen this ghost ship swear that they could smell burning canvas, rope, and human flesh. In the fog-shrouded history of England, the Tower of London was known to its victims as the Bloody Tower. Many ghosts are alleged to haunt these dark, damp dungeons and torture chambers. It is a forbidding place, complete with a moat, traitor's gate, the executioner's walk, the block, and the infamous Bloody Tower. In Britain's early days, traitors to the crown were brought by barge up the River Thames and docked at the Tower of London. Here they entered through the traitor's gate, never to leave this grim fortress. They were beheaded by a double axe wielded by the executioner, who always wore a black mask. One of Britain's greatest Elizabethans, the brave Sir Walter Raleigh, was executed here with a stroke of the vengeful axe. And his ghost still roams the evil darkness. Today, tourists from all over the world flocked to the Tower of London to view the priceless crown jewels of Elizabeth II, which are on display in the famous jewel room. Protected by day by the famous beefeaters and by night by the guards of the garrison stationed there, attempts have been made to steal these legendary gems, and all of them have failed. This is the tale of one attempt that ended in a night of terror. It is night. The changing of the guard is done, and there are no signs of life in the tower. But wait! There is a movement in the darkness in the crown jewel room. Stepping out of the shadows, we observe an evil-looking man, cloth cap pulled down over his face and mumbling to himself.
It was a good idea, Annie, old lad, hiding in the cupboard until everyone is gone. I'll just be as quiet as a church mouse and get me little old glass cutting tools out. Oh, sharp as a razor. Well, old Queen Bess, your sparklers are as good as mine. It's about time old Ernie Higgins got what's coming to him.
Slowly. The burglar began to cut into the glass case containing the crown jewels, riches that lay before his greedy grasp. Suddenly, from out of the darkness came a command.
Stop you, varmint! Methinks your cowardly heart contains evil towards me royal lady, Queen Bess of England!
Ernie's hands froze as he slowly turned his head. He screamed! Standing before him was a terrifying apparition, glowing in the dark. The ghost of Sir Walter Raleigh was standing with his severed head held in his left arm. The panic-stricken robber screamed again and started for the exit, but a dark, ominous shape blocked his way. It was the royal executioner, dressed to kill. His black mask revealed a sadistic grin as he raised the huge, gleaming, two-headed axe. Early the next morning, the guards of the garrison coming on duty discovered a gruesome scene in the royal jewel.
I look! The bloke's head's gone! Blimey!
Good Lord, Corporal, you're right! The poor blighter's been beheaded! Sergeant! Sergeant, start a search in the tower at once!
The guards searched every nook and cranny of the dark, evil dungeons. But to this day, they've never found Ernie's head anywhere in the bloody tower.